Welcome to the 52nd anniversary of the Contra Costa County Teachers of the Year program. Live from the Lesher Center in beautiful downtown Walnut Creek, California, and produced by the Contra Costa County Office of Education under the direction of Superintendent of Schools Lynn Mackey, we recognize and honor the practitioners of the noblest profession of all, teaching. Before we begin, we'd like to acknowledge that tonight's event is being held on the traditional lands of the Bay Miwok, Ohlone, and Delta Yokuts peoples. The opening number, Lean On Me, was brought to you by the award-winning Northgate High School Madrigals from the Mount Diablo Unified School District under the direction of Miss Georgia Friend. And brought to you by a corporate sponsor, Travis Credit Union. Since 1951, Travis Credit Union has been focused on financial wellness. Building relationships with schools in Contra Costa County helps foster financial literacy for students. Visit traviscu.org to learn about our statewide and national award-winning educational programs and scholarships for you. And now, presenting our MC for this evening in a return engagement. You know her from her tenure as one of the anchors on Cron 4's morning news program. Please join me in welcoming Miss Raina Harvey to the stage.
Hello, hello, everyone. Wasn't that opening number incredible? The students did a great job. We're going to have a number of performances tonight for you, just like that. So good evening and welcome to the 52nd anniversary of the Contra Costa County Teachers of the Year program. I'm Raina Harvey, and I'm so glad to be with you for my third consecutive year as host of this incredible event. Tonight, we're going to honor the teaching profession, and we're going to recognize those educators who have been chosen to represent the best of their profession for the 2024-2025 school year. The woman responsible for tonight's event is unable to be with us in person, but she wanted to make sure that she expressed her appreciation and congratulations to all the teachers that are being honored. So let's turn our attention to the screen and Contra Costa County Superintendent of Schools, Lynn Mackey.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Lynn Mackey, Contra Costa County Superintendent of Schools. Thank you for joining us this evening as we celebrate one of the noblest professions of all, teaching. I'm sorry that I'm unable to be with you here in person tonight. I am fortunate that I've already been able to visit with each of the educators and see them at work in their classroom. Every day, I see the impact that the teaching profession has on the students and families we serve, and I consider it a great honor to be able to support that work. From our small rural districts to our large urban districts, the teachers in these communities are wonderful, dedicated, consummate professionals. So thank you for being here tonight as we honor some of the best and brightest educators in Contra Costa County. Enjoy the celebration.
This celebration would not be possible without the generous contributions from our sponsors. Thanks to their support, each of the educators being honored here this evening will receive at least $1,500 to support teaching and learning in their classrooms. Please join me in expressing our gratitude for their support of the teaching profession in Contra Costa County. At the contributor level, Chris Raimondo, Diablo Vista Division of California Retired Teachers Association. Sponsor level contributors are for Imprint, AXA Region 6, Dennis Wolliver Kelly, Diablo Trophies, F3 Law, Keenan and Associates, Lozano Smith, McGraw-Hill, Mike and Sherry Maxwell, Spoken Cloth, Sun Valley Shopping Center, 32nd District PTA. At the benefactors level, First NorCal Credit Union, Allegro Copy and Print, Alton Construction, Bay Cities Paving and Grading, John Muir Health, Kaiser Permanente, Mechanics Bank, Overa Construction, Phillips 66, Robert Half International, the Rotary Club of Pleasant Hill, and The Garden. Our visionaries and very long-time sponsors of this event are Chevron, the Lesher Foundation and the Martinez Refining Company. And our corporate sponsor, Travis Credit Union. Please give all of our sponsors a warm round of applause and thanks. Now presenting Contra Costa County Board of Education President, Mike Maxwell.
Well, thank you all for being here. This is our favorite event. Sherry and I love to be at this event, love to honor teachers. As a former educator myself, you're never really a former educator, are you? As an educator myself, this is truly the best night of the year for us, and we're just happy to be here. So on behalf of the board and trustees Butler and Lewis, who are down here in front with me, and of course Superintendent Mackey, who could not be here, and we're really sad to hear that, we would like to welcome you all and thank you all for being here, and congratulations to all of the nominees and all of the winners that are here with us tonight. We're just so proud of you and so happy you've chosen to do this. Have a great night.
And next, PTA President Lisa Gross.
Good evening. I'm the president of the 32nd District PTA, which represents all of the PTAs and PTA councils in Contra Costa County. It is my privilege to join the celebration tonight as we honor the Teachers of the Year from 18 school districts, the Contra Costa County Community College District, and the Contra Costa County Office of Education. Since 1984, PTA has designated 1 week in May as a special time to honor the teachers, those who use their passion and skills to educate all of our children. It is with this in mind that we are here to help honor those who have been chosen, who have chosen teaching as their profession. The PTA at the local, state, and national level plays a role in selecting the Teachers of the Year. By naming a Teacher of the Year, we're not diminishing the contributions of the 3.1 million public school teachers who don't win this award in a given year. Rather, we look at it as a way to honor and recognize a profession that gives so much to our students and to our community. We understand the profound impact teachers have on our children. They impart knowledge, they inspire curiosity, cultivate critical thinking skills, and a love for lifelong learning. Teachers are the champions, ensuring every student has an opportunity to thrive. The 32nd District PTA is proud to be a sponsor of tonight's event, and thank you all for your continued support of for education in our county.
My name is Akinwale Ajayi. I'm a state preschool teacher at Lincoln Elementary School with West Contra Costa Unified School District. I believe what motivates me to teach every day is understanding the importance of early education for kids. For me, being a preschool teacher, I feel it's important to give little kids the necessary tools to be able to be successful moving on to kindergarten. I had a professor when I was at San Francisco State for philosophy, Ann Robertson, and she made me enjoy learning. My mother as well, who I watched teach my whole life, definitely inspired me to become a teacher. I also feel what motivates me to teach every day is understanding the importance of being an African-American male teacher. Growing up, I didn't see a lot of that, and I think the more our children are exposed to that, the better education is, not only for all, but especially for African-American students.
My name is Carrie Wilson, and I teach second grade at Walnut Heights Elementary School in Walnut Creek School District. What motivates me to teach every day is the fact that teaching is a profoundly rewarding profession. First off, I absolutely love working with children. Witnessing their growth and curiosity is incredibly rewarding. Knowing that I am making a positive difference in my students' lives by building a strong foundation for their future education is a powerful motivator. I also have a passion for teaching and enjoy building relationships with my students and their families. As a teacher, I am constantly learning and growing, whether through professional development, discovering new teaching methods from colleagues, or learning from my students. Seeing my students achieve their goals, whether it's understanding a new concept, improving their skills, or growing their confidence, brings me a great sense of accomplishment. Lastly, knowing that I am encouraging lifelong learners by instilling a love for learning and curiosity is an incredible motivator.
Hi, my name is Karen O'Leary, and I teach TK at Old River Elementary School, which is a part of the Knightson Elementary School District. The differences between being a first-year teacher in 1989 and teaching in 2024 is quite remarkable. In 1989, I was handed the California State Social Studies Framework, which had just been adopted, with the expectation of not only teaching the curriculum, but developing the curriculum, designing lessons, and purchasing the materials. It was such an exciting time to use my newly acquired knowledge of the 7-step lesson plan and creative skills to interest and educate my students on ancient times. In 2024, teachers are handed curriculum with scripted lesson plans and boxes of already purchased materials to engage and excite their students in learning. I am so fortunate to have had both of these experiences, 35 years apart. Hello, my name is Patty Barbosa. I am a school counselor at Mary Casey Black Elementary in Brentwood Union School District. What motivates me to teach every day are the 700 students and families I work with. As a bilingual elementary school counselor, I teach social and emotional lessons, empowering students with skills they can use to communicate, problem solve with peers, self-regulate their emotions, and handle what they carry in their emotional backpack. Every interaction I have with students and lessons I teach are opportunities to build stronger relationships and inspire them to become a better version of themselves. My lessons have been successful when I see a student's face light up after overcoming a struggle, watching students interact and problem solve through a conflict and assist each other with self-regulation. These opportunities give students a sense of belonging, building trustworthy relationships, and the ability to self-advocate or ask one of their trusted adults for help. My students inspire me and motivate me to make a positive difference in their lives by helping them and their families in any way I can. Hi, I'm Christy Candelaria. I teach a 2-3 combo at John Baldwin Elementary in the San Ramon Valley Unified School District. What motivates me to teach is my desire to help every student learn to read, gain confidence, and develop the skills to become a lifelong learner. I have witnessed firsthand the challenges that students with dyslexia face in school, and I am driven to change their experience and help them thrive. My mission is personal. Over 12 years ago, I watched my own son struggle with what we now know as dyslexia. Learning letter names, sounds, and blending these sounds together was a monumental challenge for him. My son was fortunate to work with an empathetic and knowledgeable teacher who, after countless hours of tutoring, opened up the world of learning to him. Her dedication inspired me to become that kind of teacher for every student in my class. I promised myself to learn how to teach in a way that made reading accessible to everyone. I have dedicated myself to learning about structured literacy instruction and evidence-based practices, and I am passionate about integrating these into my lessons to create an inclusive and supporting learning environment.
All right, that was wonderful. Before we continue with the show, I'd like to point out that during tonight's student performances, QR codes are going to appear on your screen. Now, these QR codes are going to allow you to directly support these students and their programs. That's wonderful. So thank you in advance for continuing to support the arts in our schools throughout Contra Costa County. Up next, we have the Acalanes High School String Orchestra. The Acalanes High School Orchestra carries a tradition of excellence, having received unanimous superior ratings at various festivals and competitions in its 40-plus year history. This year, the students have been invited to perform at the 2025 International Music Festival hosted at Symphony Hall in Chicago, Illinois. The students are looking forward to representing the Greater Bay Area at the California and the Select Festival this year. So please join me in welcoming the sound of the Acalanes High School String Orchestra, directed by Mr. Edwin Cordova.
Pressure falls across the land. The deadlines now are close at hand. Essays loom, demanding more. AP tests are at the door. Students race against the clock. Creases of stress, they feel the shock. applications stack up high as anxious thoughts begin to fly. And whoever shall be caught without a plan or lost in thought must face the dread of future's call and feel their hopes begin to fall. Anxiety fills the air, the weight of choices everywhere. Grit and focus start to fade as fears of failure are replayed. And though you try to hold the line, your body chills, you're out of time. For no mere teen can break away from college dreams and endless fray. But in the midst of all this fear, a soothing sound is drawing near. The band strikes up. The strings take flight. Choir's voices cut the night. In music's arms, the stress unwinds. In rhythm, peace is what you find. No matter how the deadlines flow, the notes restore your heart's tempo.
Hi, my name is Katie Watson. I teach math and science at Miramani High School in the Akalani's Union High School District. Being an educator is in my DNA. Every woman on my mother's side of the family is in education. Growing up surrounded by strong, knowledgeable women, all dedicated to the field of education, instilled in me a profound respect for teaching. In particular, my mother, a physics teacher at Camp Olindo High School in Moraga for 20 years, and my aunt, a school counselor at Mount Eden High School in Hayward for 35 years, shared tales of the highs and lows of their educational journeys. Their experiences made one thing evident: teaching is a gratifying and enriching pursuit. Now, as a teacher myself, I benefit from a robust support system of wise women educators who share insights, serve as sounding boards, and celebrate successes. My high school experience at Camp Olindo High School was marked by the influence of remarkable teachers who further inspired me to become an educator. I was drawn to the idea of giving back to the district that nurtured my academic growth. While I excelled in my math and science classes, I observed many of my peers struggling in those subjects. Throughout my adolescence and early adulthood, I continued to see the pervasive idea that some individuals are not math people. I saw teaching as an opportunity to challenge this misconception.
Hi, I'm Scott Cabral. I teach astronomy at Los Bananas College in the Contra Costa Community College District.
When I was an undergraduate at Cal, as a member of the Honor Student Society, I did free physics tutoring to students who requested it as a service provided by the society. I quickly learned that I liked helping others more than I like struggling to solve physics homework problems, and I discovered that I have a knack for explaining things simply and concisely. So I entered a career where I could do that full time. What motivates me to teach every day is that everyone in the world needs to know the awesomeness and magnificence of their home, which is the universe where we live. They need to know that when they look out into space, they see back in time. They need to celebrate the universe's diversity of stars and galaxies, just as they need to celebrate the diversity of people on Earth. And they need to know that we Earthlings should not think of ourselves as citizens of different nations, but instead as one family of inhabitants of the same planet, our personal solar system, in our shared galaxy, in our home universe.
Hi, my name is Mary Lou Bibet. I teach physical education at Carquinez Middle School in the John Sweat Unified School District. What motivates me to teach every day is the chance to positively impact every student on campus. Whether it's inspiring them to reach their personal goals or simply having fun while being active. These moments with my students remind me why I love what I do. Knowing that I play a role in teaching life skills, fostering a sense of community, and helping students discover their potential is incredibly rewarding. Each interaction, each smile, and each achievement they make fuels my passion and commitment to being the best teacher I can be. Every day, I'm grateful for the privilege to be part of my students' life's journeys, to witness their growth, and to celebrate their successes.
Hi, my name is Kimberly Charlson. I currently teach second grade at Vintage Parkway Elementary School for the Oakley Union Elementary School District. What motivates me to teach each day are my students. We laugh together, build each other up, and we care about the well-being of one another. We are a cozy little community. We become a classroom family through our smiles, jokes, hugs, high fives, and fist bumps. Our excitement for learning is infectious, and we are always eager to continue where we left off in our learning. My students, and the students that all teachers engage with on a day-to-day basis, are the future of our communities. And knowing that I'm helping in some small way to prepare them on this big journey is a worthwhile responsibility. Seeing kids engaged in learning gives me energy, and having kids request goal check-ins makes me so proud of their desire to grow. Their excitement when achieving goals, or even when seeing their peers thrive, is outstanding. And I just love being there each and every day.
Hi, I'm Andy Madsen. I'm a special education teacher at Liberty Transition for the Contra Costa County Office of Education. My students are my motivation to teach. It may sound cliche, but my students are the reason that I come to work each and every day. They come to school excited and ready to learn with so much energy and zest for life. Every day holds something new. A new goal is achieved, a new word is vocalized, or a new skill is mastered. Each student is learning different skills at different times, and my goal is meeting a vast number of medical, emotional, behavioral, social, and academic needs throughout the day. Watching my students grow and develop is pure joy. Getting to be part of their daily lives is an honor that I do not take for granted. I cannot imagine doing anything else.
Hi, I'm Michelle Good, and I'm an inclusion specialist for the Orinda Union School District. What motivates me to teach every day is the resiliency of my students. In spite of adversity and challenges, they show up every day ready to learn. They deserve to have someone on their team who values their unique ways of seeing the world. They deserve to have someone on their team who views their disabilities as a strength, not a deficit. Students with disabilities should not have to change to fit a one-size-fits-all mold of education. Rather, teachers should work to make classrooms more accessible for all types of learners. I am motivated to make schools a place where all people can learn. Too often, there are low expectations for people with disabilities. I teach because I want my students to know that they are just as capable of achieving their goals as anyone else. Through their perseverance, they can accomplish anything. My students have so much to offer their schools and communities, and I am motivated to teach so that everyone else can see what I already see in them, their limitless potential.
Is to celebrate the fantastic professionals teaching young people in Contra Costa County. Last year's Teachers of the Year are two of those outstanding educators. Please welcome to the stage the 2023-2024 Contra Costa County Teachers of the Year from Freedom High School in the Liberty Union High School District, Ana Luisa Gonzalez Ortega, and California State Teacher of the Year, Joseph Alvarico from Ignacio Valley High School in the Mount Diablo Unified School District.
To my esteemed colleagues, friends, and honored guests, magandang gabi sa inyong lahat. Good evening. When I began teaching in the Philippines back in 96, I thought success was simply having a student remember my name after summer break. Fast forward today, as the Contra Costa County Teacher of the Year and California Teacher of the Year, I've had the honor of delivering speeches, being featured in TV news segments, interviewed on a talk show, highlighted in newspaper articles, and even appearing in a TV ad on the Filipino channel. Pretty cool, right? But it gets even better. Last week, a student handed me an invitation to her grandparents' 50th wedding anniversary. When I asked why, she said, "My Lola," or grandmother, "my Lola sees your TV ad and wants to meet you." It's a reminder of the unexpected ways we leave an impact. And as if that wasn't enough, tonight, at this very moment, a documentary about our robotics team at Ignacio Valley High School is airing at the 22nd Oakland International Film Festival. So my students now joke that I'm heading to Hollywood, but I assured them the real excitement lies in grading their assignments and watching them grow. Moments like this remind me of how far I've come, yet also how much more there is to learn. Even at the peak of my career, I've realized that continuous growth is vital to staying impactful. Meeting other teachers of the year has shown me how much more knowledge and innovation there is to embrace. In education, learning never stops. It's what keeps us dynamic and ensures we offer the best to our students. Another important lesson I learned on this journey is that teaching is never a solo act. Our success is collective, fueled by collaboration with colleagues who inspire, students who push us, parents who support, and a community that enriches our efforts. Whether it's partnering with industry professionals in the classroom, collaborating with local businesses to fund my robotics team, or working with higher education to bring college courses to high school students, true success happens when we work together. So being here tonight among Contra Costa County's finest educators is a true honor. Your dedication has shaped young minds and set a standard that inspires us all. To the soon-to-be-announced 2024-2025 Contra Costa County Teachers of the Year, you're about to embark on a journey that is both humbling and deeply rewarding. While accolades are meaningful, we know the real reward lies in the success and growth of our students. Embrace this journey and let it remind us of the profound difference we teachers make every day. Thank you for your passion and commitment. Together, we're not just teaching, we're building legacies, changing lives, and maybe, just maybe, even becoming a little famous along the way. Maraming salamat po. Thank you very much.
Good evening, buenas noches. Since this is the month of September and it is Hispanic Heritage Month, I will be doing my entire speech in Spanish. Just kidding. My name is Ana Luisa Gonzalez Ortega, and it is truly an honor to stand before you alongside Joseph as one of the 2023-2024 Contra Costa County Teachers of the Year. After 28 years as a Spanish teacher, 25 of which have been at Freedom High School in the Liberty Union High School District, I can honestly say I still wake up every morning excited to see my students. I want to extend my deepest thanks to everyone in this room who has dedicated their life to education. Each of you is making a profound difference in the lives of our students and their families. The work we do is transformative. But as we all know, teaching isn't just about delivering curriculum. At times, we find ourselves filling roles like parent, friend, therapist, emotional support counselor, special education advocate, and mentor, to mention a few, but we do it with grace and heart. I also want to thank our donors for making this evening possible and for the grant we received, which you already heard, you will be receiving as well tonight. To my fellow nominees, congratulations on making it to the top 22. Out of over 8,000 teachers in Contra Costa County, just 22 are selected each year, and only two of us are chosen to represent all of our incredible colleagues. I hope you take this moment tonight to truly reflect on that accomplishment, because you are extraordinary. This experience has been nothing short of life-changing. It has given me a platform to advocate for teachers, parents, and students, to speak to future educators at St. Mary's College, to participate in our homecoming parade, give interviews, attend community events, to be invited by the Oakland A's and Giants organization to attend games and be recognized at their Teacher Appreciation Day, and to share my story with organizations like Travis Credit Union. The support from this community has been invaluable, and I am deeply grateful for it. One thing this journey has taught me is that there's always more to learn. Teaching is a never-ending process of growth. To be a good educator, you must be a lifelong learner, willing to step outside of your comfort zone and explore new possibilities. Over the past 28 years, I've learned the importance of connecting with our most vulnerable and at-risk students. And let me tell you, it's not easy. These students often have the toughest walls to break through. Teaching goes far beyond lessons in Spanish, literature, conjugation, vocabulary, and syntax. It involves mastering things, and all teachers in the classroom will know the acronyms, like classroom management, MTSS, differentiation, grading for equity, RTI, equitable practices, and social-emotional strategies. All of this while keeping up with the latest slang. The day after I was selected as Teacher of the Year, my student said, "Ortega, I was shook when I found out you got Teacher of the Year. You're the GOAT."
You're the GOAT.
Translation: Ortega, I was moved when I found out you got Teacher of the Year. You're the greatest of all time. Those of us in here back in the days would have been really hurt and offended to be called a goat. Nowadays, when they call me a goat, I say, "Aw, thank you." In all seriousness, nothing compares to the reward of seeing students succeed, whether that's discovering a new passion or experiencing success in their learning. One of my favorite quotes from the movie Forrest Gump says, "Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get." That's teaching in a nutshell. Every day is different. Every student is unique. And we face 30 plus different personalities in each classroom. There's never a dull moment. When I'm asked why I teach, the answer is very simple. Because I make a difference in the lives of our kids, but most importantly, because they make a difference in mine. There's no other profession where we have the opportunity to guide and support the next generation of adults. When you really think about it, that means we get to influence the world. Thank you for all that you do, and I wish you continued success in your teaching journey, and congratulations.
Now we would like to welcome to the stage Joe Romagna, who will introduce our first Teacher of the Year finalist, Christy Candelaria.
Good evening. Well, my name is Joe Romagna, and I'm the former principal at John Baldwin Elementary School in the San Ramon Valley Unified School District. When I first met Christy, it was about 9 years ago, and she asked me, is there gonna be a combination class next year? And then she was quick to follow up, because if there is, I wanna teach it. I love combo classes. She then grinned at me with that trademark Christy smile, and I thought to myself, wow, she is not normal. And I would quickly learn that I was right. Christy is one of a kind. She'd be one of the first teachers to volunteer to teach an on-site cohort of students in the throes of the pandemic. She would have a former student with separation anxiety come to her class before school every day just to help them with that transition. During her formal observations, she would have me observe something new she was trying so she could get constructive feedback. Who does that with an observation? And yes, when she did get assigned to teach a combination class, she sent me back to the first grade team after we had worked very hard on creating a very balanced classroom, and she kindly asked them to rebuild the class. She didn't want the most behaved students. She wanted the students that were struggling to read. Well, I don't want to paint this picture of Christy being perfect or invincible. I'm sure her husband and I could share stories. She often is kept up night wondering how she, like all teachers, can be an expert in all content areas and differentiate for all of the academic and behavioral needs of her students. And as educators, we know that education is messy. But to me, Christy represents all that is right with education. When caring, dedicated, and loving people engage in the work, we can move mountains. And as a site principal, Christy Candelaria's classroom was a place that I could go to on a tough day and be assured that students were in good hands. Students were thriving, and the love and joy of learning was evident. It's my pleasure to introduce Christy Candelaria.
Evening. Thank you all for coming tonight. So, when given this task to talk about what my students had taught me, a million things went through my head. I could not stop thinking about how my students had taught me, you know, compassion, or they had taught me humor, they taught me curiosity, they taught me how to clear the cookies on my computer. But I really spent a lot of time thinking of it, and there was this one story that just kept coming back to me in my mind, and I kept thinking about it and thinking about it. There's one story that was really profound and shaped my understanding of my job as a teacher. One day in my classroom, we were drafting an essay, and I was kneeling down at a table, and I was talking to one of my students. Behind me, I hear, hey, Miss Candy, how do you spell there? Like, over there. And not even looking back, I was like, T-H-E-R-E, and I kept working with this other student. And a couple minutes, seconds later, I hear again, wait, how do you spell there? And I'm like, T-H-E-R-E, starting to get a little annoyed because I'm like, I already said it, right? And again, I hear, Ms. Candelari, can you come here and help me? So I go over, and this student says to me, like, how do you spell there? I was like, T-H-E-R-E. And he gets his pencil, and he starts to put the pencil to the paper, and he looks at me, and he's like, I don't know what that first letter was. I can't remember that first letter. Well, that right there was a turning point for me as a teacher. I looked him in his eyes. He was terrified. He was confused. He was embarrassed. And I knew right then that I really needed to start listening to my students. I needed to kind of slow down my own agenda and what I was teaching, and that I needed to listen. So that night, I called a couple of colleagues, and I went on my computer, and I tried to think, you know, what is going on with this? And I finally, another colleague had said something about, well, it's probably something with memory. And I'm like, well, I don't think it's memory because he can remember every single score of every single sports game he'd ever attended in the last 5 years and tell me about it. So she's like, no, there's something different called working memory. And I went into my computer and I started searching, you know, what is working memory? How can I help the student? And that all came about because at the time, I took the time to listen and reach and think about that kid. He taught me to listen. Now, Maya Angelou, we all know her quote, and she says that when you know better, you do better. And as a teacher, you can't really know better until you start really listening to your students. So, from that moment on, I really worked hard to learn all that I could about dyslexia, dysgraphia. I started learning about structured literacy. I started learning the difference between what's evidence-based, what's research-based. You know, how should we be teaching kids how to read and how to spell? I actually learned that by using some methods, you can actually rewire the brain so that it's more efficient at reading. All of this really was amazing to me. And so I went ahead and I started using these things in my classroom. And I started getting great results. And I really felt, I was really compelled to share this new information that I had been learning, things that weren't in my teaching credentialing program. So I decided I needed to be an advocate for change. So starting by listening to that one student, I decided that I needed to be a leader. And so I reached out to colleagues, other principals, the district. I even wrote some letters to the state. And I said, from what we know with evidence, the way that we are teaching reading is not as efficient as other ways. We can be doing better. So the great thing, though, about teachers is that teachers don't just teach. Teachers also are really great learners. So it was really exciting for me to be on district committees for the last 10 years and do staff development and start engaging teachers from around my district to start teaching reading and writing and spelling in a different way. I now can see the change starting in our district and in our classrooms. I see the change by new curriculum being adopted, and I really see the change in our students, their abilities to read, our test scores. And it was all because of that one student who taught me to listen. Now, my journey as a teacher has truly been intertwined with lessons from all of my students. And because of that, I'm so grateful to be a teacher.
Can we please give Ms. Candelaria another round of applause? Now, please help me in welcoming Delray Elementary School Principal Maple Lye from the Orinda Union School District, who will introduce the next Teacher of the Year finalist, Michelle Good.
Hello, and good evening. My name is Mabel Lai. I'm principal at Delray Elementary out in Orinda. Michelle Good is our inclusion teacher over in the Orinda Union School District, and I am so fortunate to be able to work with her at Delray. Michelle collaborates with families, colleagues, and students to build bridges that connect learning to those beautiful and brilliant minds of the students that she works with. Her work directly supports our district and school site goals in creating a community of belonging for all, because as we all know, inclusion is a feeling. Michelle is humble and gracious, always sincerely thanking families for sharing their students with us. Tonight is our opportunity to celebrate and thank Michelle for sharing her skills, her wisdom, and her dedication with us. Please join me in welcoming Michelle Good to the stage.
Thank you, Maple. When I first began my career in education in 2013, I dreamed of all the lessons, both in and out of the classroom, that I wanted to teach my students. I wondered how I could best prepare them for the future that lay ahead. What would they need to know in order to fulfill their dreams? Would they become avid readers, writers, mathematicians, or scientists? Could I teach them the interpersonal skills they needed to forge lasting relationships with those around them? And would I, a novice teacher, be enough for them? While I contemplated these questions, I focused so much on what I would be able to teach them. What I couldn't yet see was that although I was starting my career as a special education teacher, it was really my students who had much to teach me. As teachers, we all know that the students who come into our classroom will leave their mark on our lives. We also know that some will leave a mark that is more indelible than others. There was Henry, a young man with autism who knew more about animals than any seasoned docent at the zoo. My task at the time was to teach Henry job skills and how to take public transit in San Francisco. But Henry had some other ideas in mind. He taught me that black bears live in Canada and are skilled swimmers. Did you know that the hippopotamus can run up to 28 miles per hour, even at their enormous size? Well, I didn't, but thanks to Henry, I now have my hippo facts straight. He even taught me an insider tip that when you arrive at the San Francisco Zoo, you should go to Cat Kingdom before you go to the African region, even if it's out of the way, because a crowd can gather quickly at the lion enclosure. While it's easy to smile at all of Henry's eccentricities, what he really taught me is that a person's special interests are integral to who they are. Henry and students like him are not meant to be forced into a box. There is no one-size-fits-all to learning, and as teachers, we reach our students best when we allow their passions to flourish. Thank you, Henry, for teaching me that. Then there was Owen. His first day of kindergarten was my first day as a teacher in Orinda, and boy, did Owen give me a run for my money. If you said left, Owen said right. If you said, please sit down, recess is over, Owen, with a mischievous smile, would say, no, thank you, and run out the back door. Owen resisted my expectations, but it wasn't because he wanted to break rules. It was because Owen was tired of people telling him where to go, what to do, and who to be. Owen wanted to have a say in his own life. Owen wanted to have choices. When he had this autonomy, Owen became the bright, curious, and engaging young learner who was truly a beloved member of our school community. I blinked an eye, and Owen was soon a fifth grader. For a project, He and his peers were expected to write a nonfiction report and give a presentation to their class. While he was very outgoing, Owen was sometimes shy in front of a crowd. I thought that Owen might do best if he were allowed to record his presentation in advance and play the tape for his classmates. When I told him this plan, Owen looked at me in earnest and said, "No, Mrs. Good, I just want to do what everyone else is doing." Owen taught me that while of course people with disabilities need accommodations for success, sometimes they just want to be treated like everyone else. Owen's tenacity taught me that if we set high expectations for students with disabilities, more often than not, they will exceed them. There is also Danny, who taught me that even when we face obstacles in life, we can always pick ourselves up and try again. There was Simon, who taught me that the greatest joy in life is being unapologetically yourself. There was, of course, Leo, who taught me that his typical peers would become his greatest advocates of all. While these memories are snapshots in time from my teaching career thus far, they create a picture of the biggest lessons that I have learned so far. In closing, what my students have taught me is that disability in and of itself is not the most disabling. What is disabling is our attitudes and perception of disability. My students have taught me that it's our responsibility to help them break down the barriers that limit their access to the world around them. People with disabilities are not broken or in need of fixing. People with disabilities should not have to change themselves to better fit the mold. People with disabilities must be the ultimate decision makers in their own destiny. I have also learned that they certainly do not need someone like me to speak on their behalf, so I will end here. Being my students' teacher and learning alongside them every day has truly been the greatest honor of my life. Thank you.
I'm Joshua Colley, and I teach English and Speech and Debate at Heritage High at the Liberty Union High School District. Sometimes, we teachers see ourselves as humble and overlooked in society, but I'm constantly motivated by our profession's lofty purpose and origin. From time immemorial, the ancients have noticed that we have no fur to keep us warm, claws or sharp teeth to hunt our prey. We don't even have the ability to run and hide from predators. Instead, we build and adapt the world around us, and then teach others to follow suit. This ability to pass on and acquire knowledge is key to our success as a species. It is our superpower. Because of this, all human societies have some system of education, but our particular culture has done something amazing. We have determined that the education of our children from every corner of our society, regardless of power, origin, or income, is a moral obligation, an ought in the strongest use of the term. This is a huge endeavor that requires millions of dedicated teachers to accomplish. I'm so proud to be part of this team, of this cloud of witnesses who for more than 100 years have honed their craft to better pass the flame on to their students every day and every year.
Hi, my name is Mia Carella. I teach first grade at Walnut Acres in the Mount Diablo Unified School District. I am motivated to teach each and every day by the relationships I build with my students. Many teachers love the first day of school because it is a day of excitement and anticipation. However, I find my favorite day of school is probably in April, when I can look around the classroom and know every student's strengths, interests, challenges, dreams, and use those to bring learning to life in the classroom. My mom was a director of a preschool, and I spent many weekends going to school with her, watching her plan and create a magical learning environment for her school. Today, teachers are not just instructors, but also counselors, mentors, and even tech wizards. With large class sizes, teachers face the challenges of catering to diverse academic needs while addressing the social-emotional well-being of each student. Teaching has changed, and I know it will continue to evolve, but I can confidently say there is no other job I would rather do.
My name is Pilar Alvarado, and I teach sixth grade for Lincoln Elementary at the West Contra Costa Unified School District. I believe that the most important thing you can do with your life is to help others. This belief is what led me to St. Mary's College and ultimately led to me becoming a teacher. I was drawn to St. Mary's College because of the college's motto, "Enter to learn, leave to serve." Being of service to the students of Richmond, California is one of the most fulfilling and life-altering experiences I have had in my life. So often, other educators refer to schools similar to Lincoln as stepping stones. Schools who are serving poverty-stricken communities of color are where you serve your time and get out. This exodus of teachers is what I have witnessed at Lincoln year after year. However, the students and community of Lincoln Elementary is what has kept me coming back for the past 11 years. I want to empower my students to become active members of society who make positive changes and leave lasting impacts.
Hi, my name is Ingrid Wright. I teach fourth grade at Bancroft Elementary School in the Mount Diablo Unified School District. I am motivated to teach every day because it's very rewarding to work within a professional learning community and to see children reach their academic goals. I was once told by my former principal, Linda Schuler, to love them first, teach them second. It's true that if there's no significant relationship, there will be no significant learning. I enjoy providing a developmentally appropriate learning environment in which all students are willing to take risks and grow as learners. I enjoy scaffolding lessons so that students are better able to understand the task at hand. There's no better feeling than to see a student's face light up when they have been working on a task and finally reach a new level of understanding and mastery.
Hi, my name is Jennifer Martinez. I teach band at Pittsburgh High School and Pittsburgh Unified School District. My journey to become a teacher was influenced by the exceptional educators who believed in me and saw my potential. Their encouragement not only helped me discover my passion for learning, but also instilled the desire to pay it forward. If it wasn't for one teacher in particular, my high school band director, Aaron Cross III, I wouldn't have found my passion for music and teaching. His dedication and enthusiasm for music were infectious, and he played a pivotal role in shaping my career path. Another significant part of my inspiration also comes from my parents. They attended the same middle school and were involved in their school band, where they competed against one another regularly for first chair. Their rivalry turned into a shared passion, and they continued playing through high school. Their stories and experiences were a constant presence in my life, and their dedication to music influenced my own love for it. Teaching for me is about seeing my students, hearing them, and standing with them to create opportunities for them to grow by being a constant source of support and inspiration. My parents' dedication to supporting me and my teachers' belief in me are the reasons why I'm inspired to be a supportive and passionate educator every day.
All right, are you guys enjoying yourselves so far?
Yeah.
Our next student performers come to us from the Mount Diablo Unified School District. The Madrigals at North Great High School are a premier mixed choir renowned for their a cappella performances and competitive achievements. Now under the direction of Georgia Friend, the select group of students is known for their high level of musicianship and diverse repertoire. Performing frequently at community events and local festivals, the Madrigals also excel in competitions, consistently earning top honors. This dedicated ensemble combines technical skill with emotional depth, making a significant impact both on stage and in their community. Please, as you see, welcome the Northgate Heights Madrigals, directed by teacher Georgia Friend, back to the stage.
Thank you.
Samantha Gross. I teach English at Alhambra High in Martinez Unified School District. Teaching is in some ways dramatically different than when I first started 29 years ago. One of the biggest differences, of course, is technology. I began with overhead transparencies and film projectors, which my neighboring teacher had to show me how to use. Of course, today there are some drawbacks with technology, particularly the distractions of cell phones. But what hasn't changed, what has remained constant, is the need for relevant lessons. And students still need to feel valued and respected in class, no matter how you're delivering your lessons. They need to feel safe to ask, why are we doing this? We can have a conversation around that. But they need to feel like the class is a safe and engaging place, and that they are valued as humans the moment they walk through the door. And that has not changed in 29 years of teaching. And that's part of what I love the most. Hi, my name is Tori Witte. I'm an intensive special education teacher at Iron Horse Middle School in the San Ramon Valley Unified School District. Teaching methods of today have changed and allows my students and families to play a more active role in their learning and education. In the world of special education, we are seeing more and more children diagnosed with spectrum disorders. More children need services and support such as speech, occupational therapy, adapted physical education, and behavioral therapy. We also see that when students on the spectrum have more exposure, are integrated and included into general education, it benefits not only my students, but all students and staff alike. Diversity has made teaching a much more fulfilling career, at the same time, a bit more challenging in some respects. There are increased needs in instruction, assistive technology for communication, as well as instructional time, effective ways of logging data, and creating more appropriate tools when differentiating curricula for all students in all lessons. Even though some of this can be more time-consuming, it is where I find my purpose.
Hi, my name is Virginia Vu. I'm the English language development teacher for the Moraga School District. What motivates me to teach every day? More than anything, it's my students that motivate me to teach every day. The connections I make with my students are incredibly rewarding and inspiring at the same time. I'm there as their ELD teacher to help them with their English language skills, but I learn so much from them as unique individuals with big personality. They show me what it looks like to persevere despite the fact that they are students learning English, which gives me a great sense of purpose and happiness.
Hi, my name is Andrea Canazzi. I teach TK at Timber Point Elementary School in the Byron Union School District. Teaching today has significantly changed from when I first started 20 years ago. Much of that is largely driven by the integration of technology. There's also been a great evolution of educational philosophies and thus a growing emphasis on student-centered and inquiry-based approaches, encouraging students to take a more active role in learning. There's no greater reward or bigger motivation to teach every day than watching a student have an aha moment. When you see the wheels turning and the light bulb go off in their mind, this moment is my why. It's why I dedicate the extra effort and all the countless hours to ensure every experience ignites curiosity and a zest for learning. It's a shared moment in time when you connect with your student, gleaming with pride because they finally did it.
Hi, my name is Stephanie Tompkins. I teach third grade at Happy Valley School in the Lafayette School District. My motivation to teach is my students. Developing meaningful relationships with them and witnessing their progress and achievements. Their curiosity and enthusiasm is contagious. My inspiration comes from the realization of the positive difference I can make in my students' lives, and I like that feeling. It feels good to make someone's day better, to open their eyes to a new concept, to walk with them on their learning journey, to share in their accomplishments, to lift them up when they falter, and to see their growth when they overcome challenges.
I look forward to going to work every day, developing meaningful relationships with them, celebrating student successes, both big and small.
Hi, my name is Nicole Vicknair. I teach English and leadership at Bidwell Continuation High School in the Antioch Unified School District. Teaching has changed a lot since I first started. Back then, my biggest challenge was getting students to stop talking, and now it's getting them to start. I used to have an arsenal of attention getters, a xylophone, a doorbell, call and response routines. Now these gadgets sit like relics in my classroom. Occasionally, a student will point to the doorbell and ask why I have it, and I just laugh and say, that's from the olden days when students actually talked to each other. I was so fortunate to learn from many extraordinary educators throughout my life. Foremost among them is my mother, who served as my earliest educator and laid the groundwork for my love of learning. I was also inspired to enter the teaching profession by two of my former high school teachers, Mr. Harity and Miss Y. Their classrooms were the perfect combination of a welcoming atmosphere that all students wanted to be in, paired with engaging and challenging lessons. Their classes made me fall in love with school. I realized that school is a place I loved to be under the right circumstances. And I decided then and there that I was going to be a teacher and that I too would make learning a joy.
Please now welcome to the stage Pittsburgh High School drum major student Julissa Verduzco-Galvan, who will introduce Teacher of the Year finalist Jennifer Martinez.
Good evening, family, friends, and staff of Contra Costa County. My name is Julissa Verduzco-Galvan, drum major of the Pittsburgh High School Marching Show Band. I am fortunate enough to introduce an educator who shows her love for teaching and music through perseverance and inspirations, which are lessons that guide us scholars every day. Whether it's learning to not give up, being patient with us in our struggles, or not feeling confident after a performance, she is there with us every step of the way, cheering us on no matter what. Growing up, I always admired her, the marching show band, and the strong connection she has with all of her students. With an emphasis on unifying the community, this educator works tirelessly to bring together elementary, junior high, high school, and alumni members for our program's annual showcase event. Seeing students openly express themselves during once-in-a-lifetime performances really stands out. I'm glad to say I'm living this same experience. It is with great honor I introduce someone I look up to and is motivated by, my teacher, the band director of Pittsburgh High School of 19 years, Ms. Jennifer Martinez.
Just wanted to say I'm very proud of Julissa for coming up here. Good evening, everyone. And I'm honored to be here tonight with you all and celebrating alongside the other educators being recognized. But now I want to take the time to be able to share what it is that my students have taught me. In society, we often find ourselves fixated on results, the final score, the trophy. And as a band director of a 200-piece marching band, three jazz bands, and two of four of our school wind bands, I understand the importance of performance. However, the most meaningful part of the journey begins long before we take the field or stage. At the start of each school year, as new members join the veterans, I see the heart emerge. Upperclassmen take initiative to teach new members the secrets of being a successful performer, explaining the meaning behind everything we do and why we need to keep trying. Every rehearsal, practice session, and moment spent perfecting our craft is a step towards growth. And what truly stands out to me is how grade level, music experience, or performance background never gets in the way of us coming together to achieve common goals. My students have taught me that success is not merely an endpoint, but a continuous journey of self-improvement and perseverance. This mindset inspires me to continually seek ways to improve my teaching and to apply this towards settings where I too am a learner. Teamwork is another cornerstone of this journey because no one achieves greatness alone. My students demonstrate their willingness to work together in countless ways. For instance, do you know what it's like to bring over 200 students together from 7 to 10 p.m. on a Tuesday and Thursday night, or for 5 hours on a Saturday? Now, tonight, we were supposed to have band practice, but this is the one rare occasion where we had to cancel. During these practices, we work on new material, and as we always perform a new show for every event, a big part of our preparation includes learning movements to accompany the music. I like to call these moments our band Zumba sessions, and they are some of the best of times we have together. There's a sense of humility and camaraderie as everyone works hard and learns together, watching students break down counts, encourage one another through what may be difficult at that time is a reminder we are stronger when we collaborate. This collective effort propels us forward, helping us learn to trust one another, rely on each other's strengths, and lift each other up. I have applied this to my own professional growth, recognizing the importance of collaboration and seeking opportunities to work with colleagues to enhance not only my program, but experiences for scholars. Perseverance is another profound lesson. The challenges we face and overcome shapes us into more resilient and capable individuals. We learn to handle pressure, adapt to unforeseen circumstances, and maintain our composure in the face of adversity. One memorable example of this came during a performance event we had been planning for some time. We had two performances scheduled, one with all members of the program and another that was a smaller group. A week before this event, I was informed that the smaller group exceeded the capacity limit this organization had suddenly imposed, so I had to divide them in half to create two even smaller performance teams. Initially, I felt a surge of anger and frustration, but I knew reacting impulsively would not help. Breaking the news to the small group after all their hard work and anticipation was incredibly difficult. Their heartbreak was painfully evident. But in the following moment, I couldn't have been prouder. These performers acknowledged one another with appreciation and support. They understood this outcome was beyond our control and remained committed to delivering two strong performances. Their grace in the face of disappointment reminded me how important it is to lead by example, as my actions could potentially influence their reactions. But above all, my students have shown me that I am a learner alongside them. By understanding their interests in music, trends, and suggestions, learning becomes a team effort. I could not do my job effectively without their willingness to engage and participate. And I often say the energy you give is the energy you receive, because in a collaborative environment where people feel valued and respected, we create a more engaging and fulfilling experience for everyone involved. They've helped me grow through challenges, whether it's adapting to changes in technology, funding, or overcoming socioeconomic barriers. And through it all, I've held on to one simple truth that my dad would say to me, that I do it for the kids. I like to think my students are a reflection of my work, but in reality, I am a reflection of the heart they have for being performers, ambassadors, and scholars. It's not just about teaching them music, but about being there with them, learning, and growing together. The Pittsburgh Band Program might be known as the Pride of Pittsburgh, but it's the students who are the heartbeat that keeps our traditions alive. So the greatest thing my students have taught me is that they truly are the heart of Pittsburgh. Thank you.
Next to the stage will be Isabella Ippolito to introduce our final Teacher of the Year finalist, Nicole Vicknair.
Good evening, everyone. Tonight, I have the privilege of introducing one of the great teachers from Bidwell High School, Ms. McNair. She comes from a family of educators, and passion for teaching shines through in everything she does. As a current student of hers, I've had the pleasure of being in her English and leadership classes, and I've also had the honor of serving her as teacher's assistant. Ms. McNair brings a hands-on approach to learning using strategies that keep us motivated and engaged. Whether she's bringing a mystery story to life with her animated expressions or leading a leadership activity, every lesson she teaches is filled with excitement and creativity. Her outgoing and energetic personality makes the classroom a welcoming and fun environment. Ms. McNair has a natural talent for building strong relationships with her students while maintaining professionalism. She understands each of us and is willing to adapt her teaching style to meet our individual needs. She values our thoughts, listens to our input, and in turn, she has become not only an amazing teacher, but also a mentor. As many of us say, she is truly a big ball of sunshine in our lives. Please join me in welcoming Ms. McNair.
Can we hear it for Bella? There are so many things I have learned from my students. I could tell you how they've made me a better mother, a more compassionate person, a better citizen, but today I'm going to tell you what I've learned from my students about being a better teacher. When I started teaching 18 years ago, engaging students was really challenging. And it might surprise you to know that the kids who taught me the most about engaging teenagers were 6 years old. That's right. I taught kindergarten for 2 years, and it completely transformed my approach to teaching high school. And that's because kindergartners are enthusiastic learners. I mean, joy and curiosity is just oozing from them. On any given day, I could have walked into that classroom and said, "Today we're gonna learn about the letter A," and they would just like erupt in cheers. And sometimes, coming from high school, by the time students reach 11th and 12th grade, that zest for learning has faded. And so I feel so lucky that I got to experience that, because it really made me consider how kindergartners learn. They learn in bright, cheerful classrooms full of music and movement and fun. And I thought, I can do that in high school. And so when I transitioned back to high school, I brought kindergarten with me. I decorated my room in bright, cheerful colors. I made interesting bulletin boards, and I incorporated fun and play into every one of our high school lessons. And the response was immediate and overwhelming. My students loved learning. I can't tell you how many students have told me they like to just be in my room because it's cheerful and welcoming. They love coming to English because it's fun and engaging. And so the lesson was so clear. Students want learning to be an adventure, not a chore. And that's true for all students, even big students. Now, play and fun is super important, but it has to be paired with high expectations. And that's something I learned overhearing a conversation between two of my students. One student had walked in upset. She felt that she had received an A from a teacher out of pity. You see, she had completed a math test, and she had received an A, but she had left the whole back page blank. And her friend, who had also taken the test, completed the whole thing and also received an A, felt that was very unfair. And the first student said to her really sincerely, "Oh, come on, you know he's just being nice. He thinks I'm too stupid to do those problems." Now, I don't for a minute believe that my colleague gave a student an A out of pity, but it almost doesn't matter because that's what she thought. And so it became really clear to me, if we lower our expectations for any reason, what it communicates to the students is that we don't believe in them, that we don't think they can do it. In their words, that we think they're too stupid. And I knew I never wanted that miscommunication to happen in my class. So from that moment on, I made sure I stated learning targets for all to hear, and I assessed every student on that same expectation. I tailored my support to help them reach it, but I didn't tailor the expectation. Another thing that I hear far too often in my classroom is students tell me that they received a D in their class because their teacher hates them. Now, you have to reflect on how can that be happening so often? Because seriously, I hear this all the time. And so it really made me understand the importance of objective grading rubrics and feedback systems. Because if students can measure their own growth and assess their own skill, it removes blame from the teacher and puts the onus of learning on the student. A student has to know that their grade is composed of skills acquired and content knowledge, and not how a teacher feels about them personally. Another really important lesson I've learned from students happened on the first day of a really challenging year. I was engaging in a getting to know you activity with my students, and kind of out of nowhere, one of them loudly declared for the whole class to hear that she hated everyone in the classroom, including me. Now, it took me a lot of time and consistent effort to change her outlook and heal her hurt. But that effort and that time highlighted for me the importance of a safe and secure classroom. Taking the time to let students get comfortable with each other and get comfortable with me is so important, because a student isn't going to raise their hand to ask or answer a question if they're afraid of ridicule or judgment. A supportive classroom is the foundation of a productive academic environment. And finally, my students have taught me that they do not want to learn in classrooms where shame or managing behavior or making examples of students to manage behavior is happening. Shame doesn't change behavior. It only makes students dread coming to school. And if students don't come to school, then we can't teach them. There's a really big difference between a student hearing, Willa, late, again, and Willa, I'm so glad you could make it, come on in. Those small positive interactions make a huge difference to the students. In the end, my students have been my greatest teachers. They've taught me that learning should be an adventure filled with curiosity and joy, no matter the age. They've taught me that high expectations communicates belief in their potential, and that objective grading systems allow them to see their true capability. They've highlighted for me the importance of a safe and secure classroom where every student feels valued and heard. Thank you to my students for teaching me that education is a shared journey, full of opportunity for growth and discovery for both student and teacher alike. Thank you.
All right, can we get another round of applause for all those incredible teachers? That was awesome. Well, continuing the legacy of great teachers, we want to please welcome the class of 2024-2025 Teachers of the Year from the Contra Costa County School District, the Office of Education, and the Contra Costa Community College District. Can we have a round of applause?
Akinwale Sean Ajayi from Lincoln Elementary School in the West Contra Costa Unified School District. Come on up on stage, you all.
Pilar Alvarado from Lincoln Elementary School in the West Contra Costa Unified School District.
Patty Barbosa from Mary Casey Elementary School in the Brentwood Union School District.
Mari Lou B. Batt from Carquinez Middle School in the John Sweat Unified School District.
Scott Cabral from Los Medanos College in the Contra Costa Community College District.
Christy Candelaria from John Baldwin Elementary School in the San Ramon Valley Unified School District.
Mia Corella from Walnut Acres Elementary School in the Mount Diablo Unified School District.
Joshua Cawley from Heritage High School in the Liberty Union High School District.
Kimberly Charlson from Vintage Parkway Elementary School in the Oakley Union Elementary School District.
Michelle Good from the Orinda Union Elementary School District.
Samantha Gross from Alhambra High School in the Martinez Unified School District.
Andrea Canazzi from Timber Point Elementary School in the Byron Union School District.
Andrea Madsen from Liberty Transition School, a part of the Contra Costa County Office of Education.
Jennifer Martinez from Pittsburgh High School in the Pittsburgh Unified School District.
Karen O'Leary from Old River Elementary School in the Knightson Elementary School District.
Stephanie Tompkins from Happy Valley Elementary School in the Lafayette School District.
Nicole Vicknair from Bidwell Continuation High School in the Antioch Unified School District.
Virginia Vu from Joaquin Moraga Intermediate School in the Moraga School District.
Katie Watson from Miramonte High School in the Okolonis Union High School District.
Carrie Wilson from Walnut Heights Elementary School in the Walnut Creek School District.
Tori Witte from Iron Horse Middle School in the San Ramon Valley Unified School District.
Ingrid Wright from Bancroft Elementary School in the Mount Diablo Unified School District. And with that, let's give every one of these teachers another round of applause and appreciation.
Thank you, Ms. Harvey. Before we continue, I just want to let you all know that tonight's festivities can be viewed on the Contra Costa County Office of Education YouTube channel and EdTV, a service of Contra Costa Television. And for those of us still tethered to cable, we can watch on Comcast Channel 32 in West County, Comcast Channel 24, and AT&T U-verse Channel 99. So we want to thank the CCTV team who is with us tonight, ensuring this program will be available to those of us who cannot be here in person. And thanks to Ms. Harvey, tomorrow morning, our two Teachers of the Year will be interviewed live on Cron 4 around 10:45 a.m. So thank you, Ms. Harvey, for that.
Thank you, guys.
And we want to thank you for all you've done over the past 3 years supporting this program and the teachers here in the county. I hope you've enjoyed this relationship as much as we've enjoyed having you here at this event. So thank Ms. Harvey one more time for us.
I love the teachers and I love the students. Like, my mother is an educator, special education for 30 plus years. So I appreciate all the hard work that you all do.
Next, please show your appreciation for the students who performed this evening and the teachers who are responsible for helping them hone their talents and organizing their appearances here today. Don't forget the QR codes in your programs and on your screens. Northgate High School Madrigals and director Georgia Friend and the Okolonis High School String Orchestra, who you'll hear from again, with teacher Edwin Cordova. Before we move on, I'd like to thank my colleagues at the Contra Costa County Office of Education for their work. There are many volunteers, many people who are unsung, who've been working behind the scenes to ensure that this happened today. We want to thank you all, and I want to thank the Communications Office team, especially Julie Everhart, Daniel Jones, and Nikki Mora for putting on this production tonight. So please give me a hand. Thank you. Now, on behalf of Superintendent of Schools Lynn Mackey, it's my privilege and honor to thank every single educator here in Contra Costa County for the work they do every day in every classroom to help students reach their potential. As Superintendent Mackey has said previously, this award is more than an individual accomplishment. It's an acknowledgement of the dedication and professionalism displayed by teachers throughout this county every day. As we get closer to revealing the two County Teachers of the Year, I am going to ask the four finalists to step forward into the center one more time to be recognized. Christy Candelaria, Michelle Good, Jennifer Martinez, and Nicole Vicknair. And now, in their final official act as reigning Teachers of the Year, we're going to ask Ana Luisa Gonzalez Ortega and Joseph Alvarico to come announce this year's winners. Come on up. And Daniel, you can start that drum roll whenever you like.
I'm gonna take super long just to make it more mysterious. Well, here we go. I don't want to. No, I'm kidding. Congratulations to the first 2024-2025 Contra Costa County Teacher of the Year, Jennifer Martinez.
This is so nerve-wracking. And to our second 2024-2025 Contra Costa County Teacher of the Year, congratulations to Nicole Vicknair.
All right, let's have another round of applause for our winners this year and for all the teachers on this stage. And also a round of applause for all of you in the audience, all the educators that are also there. Thank you all for joining us this evening. We've had a great time celebrating the best of public education and the teachers who are responsible for all the success we've seen. I mean, the students are incredible. Thank you again to our supporters, including our corporate sponsor, Travis Credit Union. Good luck to the teachers who will represent Contra Costa County at the state competition. And I hope all of you have a great school year, because that's what it's all about. Thank you again, and good night, everyone.